All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Wisconsin High School Esports Association State Championship Informational Meeting. I have quite a bit to cover, and I'm going to try to keep it short and fast so that way everybody can get back to their evening. If you do have any questions at any time during this, please make sure that you go ahead and submit them into the Twitch chat, and I will do my best to answer your questions in real time. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get this started. So for starters, I'm going to be putting the down payment in order to reserve this space hopefully this week, if not early next week. So that way then we have a confirmed location. I'm getting multiple estimates right now as far as t-shirts go and trophies. So the cost breakdown that I'll show in a little bit, we'll talk a little bit more about where those numbers come from and how they may fluctuate. But if you would, out on the Wisconsin High School Esports Association website, I have made a special tab for the championship information. So if I go ahead and click on this, again, the state championship is going to be April 13th, and it's going to be a physical tournament. It's going to be at Game On in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. The people who will be attending are going to be semifinalists for each game. Smash is going to run a little bit different, so I want to make sure that I talk a little bit of how Smash is going to work. Right now, the cost is going to be $20 per student, and that is going to include a t-shirt that'll say state finalist that every student will get to have. I do have a sign-up form down there as well that I will talk about. On top of that cost, we're also going to be looking at that's got trophies in it, and you'll see more on the cost breakdown. But every student should get to walk away with something. If you're interested in coming to just spectate, I know there's been some people that have asked just about wanting to come and participate. It'll be $5 for spectators. I am looking for some volunteers to potentially help. I know Marquette is looking to come. Potentially promote their new program because they'll be recruiting for a 2019 varsity team as well. So they're going to be coming. I'm talking to Concordia University, and then actually the one of the owners of Game On, Fond du Lac, is also a professor at Marion University, and they are actually looking at developing a program as well. As far as food goes, they have talked to, there's a barbecue place in Fond du Lac that has a food truck. So they're looking to bring that in. They know to try to keep it to about $5 a meal. So he may steer clear of barbecue in general and actually look at serving things like pizza and some kind of quick and easy burgers, little fryer stuff, stuff like that. The way that I've really broken down the schedule is to hopefully then allow that if schools want to go and get lunch beforehand, they don't necessarily have to eat on site, or they can hopefully finish in time in order to get some dinner as well. What I do need every school to do, regardless if you think that you're going to make it to the semifinals or not, I guess I should say it is mandatory that if you get to the semifinals, you are traveling to Fond du Lac to participate in this tournament. It's imperative that we actually follow through and everybody who makes it to the semifinals makes it. If you have a couple of students that decide to back out, please hold them responsible because we are having to put down a down payment on a lot of this, and yours truly is having to put down more than makes me extremely comfortable, if I'm being completely honest. But in order to make sure that this happens, I'm committed to going out on a limb here for this to work. So I do need everyone to go ahead and then fill out this t-shirt form. So that way, as we're progressing through, I can actually get specific t-shirt sizes. One of the companies that I talked to today said that as long as we get like 125 of the t-shirts sent to them by Tuesday night, the week of, and then the other 50 to 75 by that Thursday night, then they would be able to turn that around in under 24 hours and get all those t-shirts out to us as well. I know there are some students that are looking to participate in multiple games. Just note that there is most likely going to be some overlap, especially if you're in Smash Ultimate, because it's just the way that the schedule broke down, and trying to get everything done in one day, It's a lot to try to get done, but I'm pretty sure that we can get this done. And then just go ahead and choose your size. If your size is not on here, please just reach out to me and let me know exactly what size that you want. And I'll fill out this form for you, but these are pretty much the standard sizes. And I should have every single school listed here as well, even some schools that aren't participating this semester, just to cover my bases. Again, if you're interested in volunteering as well, I do have... Okay, I can turn my voice up. Sorry about that. There's no cost for coaches right now. So cost is only for participants right now. As far as coaches go, there would be no cost for coaches to participate in this. We just really need you there and to be active. Trying to schedule all the transportation and wrangling students to get into this location, I think is extremely important. If you're a volunteer or a caster, I'll make sure that there's no cost as well for those, just because it's important to have that infrastructure that's available there. So that way we can run a smooth event and put on something that we're proud of and something that students are proud of participating in as well. So if you're interested in volunteering as well, I do have a little volunteer form. I'm really looking for some sort of commentators. I won't be able to do League of Legends like I normally do. If you and a friend are interested, I just kind of ask that you give me a little bit of a preview of your ability. So that way then we kind of have an idea of where to go. I have a couple volunteers kind of right now for Smash and Rocket League. So just kind of a heads up there. And then if you're interested in doing like a little player interview, whether, you know, if that's each person, if you want to interview just people from your school on stream or something along those lines, I'm open to that as well. So anything that you can do is much appreciated. I do see some questions right now as far as looking at the schedule, so I'll go ahead and start talking about some of that. We'll have open registration and check-in. Now, if your game doesn't start until later, we'll have people at a registration station basically to get you kind of checked in as you're coming in and stuff like that. Because I get that some schools may only have a League of Legends or may only have an Overwatch team, so you don't need to be there all day for this. But in order to get started easiest, I figured we would start with Rocket League and Smash. Smash, we need some people in order to bring their Switches. As of right now, and I'll talk about this a little bit later as far as breakdown goes, but Smash, they have 15 TVs on the wall. They have 2 Switches available in-house right now. So hopefully if we can provide roughly, if we can get up to 6 Switches, then we should be good. If we can get more, it'll be even better to try to make sure that this stays on time. If we look here, Rocket League, based upon some of the average times, I talked to Not Your Parents Basement, who hosts all of the Racine ones, a best of 5 is taken between 20 minutes upwards to 40 minutes. So trying to really keep that in mind. So if this finishes early, then we might even be able to run a little bit ahead of schedule here on the best of 7 and then the awards as well. Again, I'm trying to stagger everything so that we can do an award. I do see down there in the chat that I missed something, that there should be an award section down here, so I apologize for that. I'm hoping that all of this runs on time and that we can finish by 9. I know Game On is going to be pretty flexible with everything that we're trying to do, and let's just hope, let's pray, whatever you got to do to hope that technology is on our side and that it works seamlessly, okay? But I do want to make sure that there's a little award time there. They're going to try to have a backdrop to where we can actually do like a little ceremony and that as well. So we can get you on stream, showcase your schools. Again, I'm working on getting runner-up trophies and I'm working on getting finalist trophies. Depending on the cost breakdown, I may be able to get some medals and stuff like that, but we'll see. There's a couple of variables that I'll have to talk about. If we look at League of Legends again, because we have two divisions, so we'll have to try to stagger these. So while the state championship is happening for Rocket League, the pod systems that they have at Game On will allow us to kind of stagnate these games. So that way, the semifinals will finish for Division One, will be underway with the Division Two finals, best of five. And given the current state of League of Legends right now, a game should finish under 30 minutes. So if we do a best of five, that's 2.5 hours. So in this, I have from 1:30 until 2:30. So this might actually need to be reworked a little bit as well. But again, this is tentative and hoping that everything works well. They do have a few additional places that we can set up additional PC. So if we need to, we can kind of move some of this stuff around. Yeah, Overwatch, we would need an award ceremony down here as well. So that's my fault. I accidentally cropped too much. I've been working quite a bit on this. And then Smash, we're going to do group stages, right? So at the end of this current semester of competition, so at the end of 8 weeks, the standings that we have for Smash is going to be then the overall school rankings. And then we're going to go into individual play at the state championship to see who the overall best Smash player is. So much like the World Cup for soccer, you'll be in a group stage. We're going to take all the participants to figure out that morning how many total participants that we have. And we'll just do a random draw into group pools. We'll obviously try to make sure that most schools don't have other school members within their pool. So that way we can kind of get this equal distribution of gameplay. Knockout stages, I'll talk a little bit more about in just a bit. And then as you can see, I tried to stagger a little bit of the awards and finals so that way then we can try to stream this. So I'm hoping, I say hoping, but I really want to make sure that we do have a capture card available so that we can stream the finals for Smash. So, link test, the way that it's going to work is every school gets to bring five students from Smash. And again, I'll talk about that down at the bottom. So you can bring your best five and they'll be randomly dropped into different pools. So I guess we'll just kind of scroll down here a little bit here. Division One and Division Two for League of Legends. Each division has 12 teams. So the top four seeds will go ahead and get considered to be a first round bye, and then all other schools will be placed into seeds as well based upon the standings. So, in the way that the tiebreakers are this semester are based upon match times as well. So, the higher the seed that you get usually means that the lower match rate that there was as well. So, I didn't get any feedback on the Discord channel when we were looking at this, but round one, so this is going to be Wednesday. And then this is Thursday. So those are already League of Legends days. So there shouldn't be an issue as far as overlap between these two. And then obviously, so this is considered to be round one. This is round two, semifinal one, semifinal two, and finals will be played at Game On in Fond du Lac. Overwatch is kind of up in the air right now, as far as there are 14 teams currently. Appleton will let me know by Thursday as to whether or not that they need to drop out, and they're looking to drop out because they don't have students that show up every week. They've got to only field a team for one match, I believe. Other than that, they've basically had to forfeit all their matches. So this could switch to a 13 team, which is unfortunate given that it's so late in the season, but it is what it is, right? We have to do with what we can. It's a best of five. So this is three wins for Overwatch. So right now, what you're currently playing is you're playing all four maps just because that's going to help with standings and stuff like that. So this best of five here. So you need to get three wins. I left this one blank because I know there were some issues previously where we talked about overlapping between JV on Thursday. So April 8th is Monday, so that's the normal one. And if it works, if we should keep it the same, if we run then the second round of Overwatch being on the 11th. So if that works, please let me know. Otherwise we could do it Tuesday. So that way then we're not overlapping everything on Thursday as well. I think it's smarter to do it Monday, Tuesday, so that way we know already definitively who's going to be the semifinalists to go on to Game On Tuesday. So that way too, then I can make sure that I get that t-shirt order in on Tuesday. So if no one opposes anything that we do it on Tuesday, I say let's go on Tuesday. So please make your voice heard if you disagree that it shouldn't be on Tuesday and that it should stay on Thursday. So Rocket League is going to be a best of five until the finals, and then the finals is going to be a best of seven. This one, again, round one is going to be on Tuesday, the normal Rocket League day. But then the other round here is going to have to be done on that Wednesday. So again, there's got to be a little bit of these overlaps. I know it's a lot to try to get into that 1 week right before, and hopefully we don't have some freak storm or something along those lines, but I really want to try to get these done that week because we can't reschedule. We don't have the flexibility this week because the 3 weeks prior that we kind of have off are going to be for a ton of games that need to be rescheduled right now. Those 3 weeks are also spring break weeks across the state. So we need to be really, really flexible with our communication up until this week of playoffs because we need all matches to be reported and finished before we can get to playoffs. So, again, April 10th is going to be this round to figure out who then goes into the semifinals. Then this would allow me to, on that Wednesday, to put in another round of t-shirt orders into our t-shirt provider. So that way, then we can turn around. That way, I can make sure that everybody gets the right size t-shirt that they're paying for. Correct. No new heroes will be allowed in playoffs, kind of like League of Legends as well. So Smash. If there's no questions on Rocket League, I'm going to move on to Smash. If there is a question, let me know. I know this too. Again, there's a lot of asterisks right now. But I know there's a couple of Rocket League teams that are struggling with academic eligibility and a couple of other little things too. So this bracket could change. I know it's unfortunate that it's coming this late in the season, but again, sometimes we just have to be flexible. And it is what it is. So. Hazy boy, am I saying so too much? Is that what you're getting at? Smash is going to work in group stages. If you've never watched the World Cup, basically what this is going to be is that we take our pool of students and we divvy them into equal pool numbers. So if we have 60 students, the goal would be to hopefully get 10 pools of six. So that way, then you have to play everyone in your pool. Ties are going to be determined by stocks left per match. So if it's three stock and you finish with all three stocks left, then you get plus three. That's going to be the way that we have to determine ties because they're potentially, depending on how the pools work out, we may have an odd number of pools. Which means then a couple of random pools will get a third place team or third place person entered into the bracket. So pool winners will go on one side of the bracket, so say on this side, and then the runner-up will go on this side. Traditionally, the way that the World Cup works is the winner of Pool A will go here. The runner-up from Pool B will go here. The winner of Pool B will go here. And the runner-up from Pool A will go here. So basically, we'll just fill out this entire bracket. And again, the bracket size could change based upon the number that we have jump up into the single elimination round. But ultimately, we will crown the overall champion for Smash that way. As far as CSGO, there is no timetable right now to adding CSGO to the High School Esports Association, mainly because of the M-rated. It's too hard of a sell right now to try to get first-person shooters into high schools at this point. So I apologize to those of you asking for that. As far as cost breakdown goes, 2 seconds, I have to let my dog outside.
I hear you, bud. Well, you rang the bell. Go outside.
Sorry about that. So looking at the cost breakdown right now, try to zoom in so it's a little bit easier to see. So right now I'm projecting 175 students at $20 a person. So that's going to come out to about $3,500 that comes up. I expect this number to honestly go down. So I'm trying to keep some of this cost up right now. Also, these costs, these expenses here, don't calculate in for taxes as well. So I'm trying to work on some of that. And I'm also not banking on this money coming in from a corporate partner that is looking to advertise with us during the state championship here. So 3,500 is basically what we would have to work with 175. There's not a huge difference. So if our t-shirts come down, so if we start to get kind of strapped for cash and this comes down to 175, sorry, coaches, you aren't going to get a t-shirt. You're probably already getting a Discord Hype Squad t-shirt coming, thanks to crypto. But we'll see. So right now, I'm aiming for 200 shirts, so that way, coaches, you can get a t-shirt as well to kind of show off. Right now, the current bid that I'm looking at from Mid-City Sports and Heartland was $6 a t-shirt. I have a second bid coming in from Geiger, which is here in Waukesha, so I'm going to wait to see what that comes up. I guess if you don't want a shirt, then don't sign up for one. But so the venue's costing us $2,000. I have to put a $1,000 deposit down out of my account so that way we can reserve the space so that way we have it all day. So would really, really like to make sure that that comes back to me. Championship trophies. I talked to Geiger. The winner of each game is going to go ahead and get a. It's like a 15-inch trophy that it will say like the 2019 Wisconsin High School champion for League of Legends or something along those lines. Keegan, please make sure that you just fill out the form again so that way I just have a giant list of everybody that I need to contact and coordinate. I'd appreciate that. Thank you. Runners up would then also get a second place trophy. It's like a 12 and a half inch trophy. You guys voted upon which trophies you would like to have in the Discord channel. And then this is kind of a question mark category right now, but I want to do raffle prizes throughout the day. So I was looking at getting a couple of, Blizzard gift cards, Riot gift cards, stuff like that. So that way we can give away pizza gift cards, stuff like that, just so you can kind of get some material out there. As far as the updates on the competitive and casual divisions for League of Legends next year, I don't think it's going to happen. In order to keep a lot of what we're doing, we tried to come up with that new advisor checklist. So that way, schools actually have to go through a process now before they're even allowed to register for the semester of competition. Next semester, as well, we're going to be having to talk about splitting up divisions or sorry, games by semester. There's way too much going on this semester, and I know it's stressing out a lot of our advisors and coaches. So we're probably going to have to split like Overwatch in the fall and Smash in the fall, and then League of Legends, Rocket League in the spring. It's just been way too much, especially with all the rescheduling and everything that we've had to deal with. It's unfortunate, but it just is what it is. If you're not necessarily getting everything that you want to out of the JV league, you have, you know, four or five different nationwide leagues that you can sign up for. There's the high school esports league. There's Play VS. There's the High School Star League Collapsed. There's also the Youth Esports Association, and there's a couple others that you can sign up for, but they cost, you know, a couple $100 to register a team. So depending on what you want to do, otherwise JV is honestly the best that we have for you. I would like to next year run a little bit other tournaments as well, but like weekend tournaments and invitationals and stuff like that. So, so bottom line right now, with sponsorship or with corporate partners following through, we're looking at about $3,500. And again, this doesn't have tax, so some of these are going to have some additional cost on them as well. So right now, there would be a surplus of $438, but I'm not looking to make any sort of profit off of any of this. This is all going to go back to the students that are participating, that are there the day of the event. I would probably take some of this and probably buy lunch for volunteers or dinners for volunteers and stuff like that. Trust me, Flying Pig, I would love to pocket this, but you know, I think I've probably over the last like 2 years, I've probably spent almost $300 anyways just to get this up and running. So between the website, social media campaigns, and all this other stuff. So I'm not in this for the money. All right. I'm here to try to do something cool for students and make something big happen in the state of Wisconsin. So that's pretty much a breakdown of the cost right now. This money would go back down to zero at the end of the day. So if there is still a surplus for whatever reason, whatever money is left over would go into filing for nonprofit organization. The shoutcasting form is on the website. It's under the championship, under the volunteer form. So if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to me and ask me directly. You can email me. You can shoot me a message on Discord. You can tweet me, whatever you want to do. Just get a hold of me so that way we can make sure that all these are clear. I'm trying not to ping everybody in the Discord channel. I'm trying not to flood everyone's email. But it's really important that we make sure that everything gets organized. Going to charity is actually a really good idea. And I would definitely like to next semester as well host a Extra Life Gaming Marathon as well. So if you're not familiar with Extra Life Gaming Marathons, check it out. It's fantastic. It's a 24-hour gaming marathon. We've raised thousands of dollars for children in hospitals around the state of Wisconsin, and it's a really good time. So if you don't have any questions, I'm going to go ahead and end the video now. But if you have anything, please don't hesitate to reach out to me. I'm here to help, okay? I have considered posting on Reddit. I've actually been invited to about 7 different Discord channels. So there are multiple channels that I'm a part of right now that are working on creating a Midwest region, kind of like a board. So schools from Wisconsin would play those in Illinois, Indiana, Michigan, and Wisconsin. So kind of like a Champions League. So if you win like our division, the top 4 schools would then play the top 4 schools from Illinois, Michigan, Indiana, Ohio, stuff like that. So working on some cool stuff like that. I'm definitely hoping that there's going to be time for a coaches thing to play games. I would definitely love to throw down on some Smash. I can bring my N64 so we can have the best version of Smash to play, and the one that I happen to be the best at. I'd love to do some student versus coach games, especially during during the school year, like little fun little tournaments on the end. If you participated in the Polar Vortex Rumble, myself, the Cedarburg coach, and a couple of other coaches were participating in that throughout the day. So trust me, I love to play this as much as you guys do. I got up to silver 2 today, so I'm pretty proud of myself for that. So, yeah. As far as total number of switches that we need, I would love to have, if we have 60 students participating, I would love to have 10 switches total. So, yeah, silver 2, clean, baby. So 10 switches if we can get it. If we have to do work with 7 or 8, then that's what we have to work with. It might just alter our schedule a little bit. But yeah, so. Yeah. So if there's no other questions, I'm going to go ahead and get running. But please just go ahead and follow up with me if you have anything, okay? Awesome, Sanic Gamer, that would be awesome if you could get us 4. Player interviews I think would be super cool. I'd love to come up with like some predetermined questions, so that might be some homework that we have to get done, just so that way we can ensure that, you know, all the questions are appropriate for school and stuff like that, so we're still following protocol and rules and stuff like that. So, but I would love to get some genuine interviews of students, even if it's just how you thought that this semester went, how you thought the competition was. I don't know. What's your favorite skin? Whatever. So, yeah, I'm totally open to interviews. I would love to make more. I've been looking at what the Illinois group does, and they actually have, like, internships that they offer. Like, so if you want to write for the Illinois High School Esports Association, you can do that. If you want to do guest shoutcasting, you can do that as well. So there's a ton of different opportunities, and we are always trying to make this better. I appreciate everybody's flexibility. It's been a roller coaster of 2 years making this happen. To think last year, last fall, we started this thing with 7 schools and about 75 kids. We are up to 31 high schools participating across the state and have over 700 kids participating. So it's growing exponentially, and it's been a roller coaster of a ride. So, and I'm really excited to see what next year has to offer. But for now, we have to get this state tournament, state championship done and run successfully, so we can start looking for the future as well. So this is my main goal, is to put on something super cool for you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and head out now. I'm going to upload this video as well to YouTube. So if you weren't able to watch this entire video, you can still go back through. If you need to share this with anybody, you're more than welcome to. And if you really want to, you can go ahead and smash that like button. Okay. Oh, sorry. Playing elite. If I play in the league tourney, you will not be able to participate probably in both. Because if you look at the scheduling, right, group stages, knockout stages. So depending on, there's a lot of overlap here. So you might have to pick which one that you're going to participate in. So actually, yeah, I mean, unless you're in this semifinal, but even still, then you wouldn't be able to participate in the group stages like you need to. So unfortunately, you're going to have to pick which game that you'd like to focus on. So I apologize, but that's just the way that the cookie crumbles there, but I apologize. Awesome. Thanks, Alex. Appreciate you bringing those 3 switches. Shirts, I'm working on it. They're kind of relatively generic. It's just going to be the logo on the chest. It's going to say state finalists underneath our Wisconsin esports logo. And then on the back, Game On is going to have a sponsorship section. And I'm probably going to throw the Discord logo on there too, because we have the Discord Hype Squad on there. I'm waiting to hear back from our sponsor to see if to get their logo on the back as well. So it's honestly nothing super fancy right now. It's our first time. So in the future, I would love to have students submit designs and stuff like that. But for right now, our first time, it's all that I got for you. I'm sorry. It's not easy working 40 hours a week and then doing this. And then up until 2 weeks ago, I was also working 20 to 25 hours a week at the grocery store down the road. So now I quit. So now I got more time dedicated to you guys and to make this happen. So, yeah, it's the first physical tournament. So I'm learning a lot. So, all right, I'm going to go ahead and end the stream. If you have more follow-up questions, just reach out to me on Discord. And I would love to continue to keep chatting about this. Okay? Have a good night. And good luck to the teams playing tomorrow, which is Montello against Tosa on our stream. I'm also running a new promotional. I'm going to do a giveaway tomorrow as well for League of Legends. You actually have to guess the number of total kills within the game. So I'm trying something new. Come check us out, even if it's just a throw and a guess and maybe win a prize. Otherwise, have a good night, and I'll see you later.